In this video, we're going to go through how to set up posts and pages correctly for elegant themes. So the first thing you need to do is we're going to go into an existing post. So we're just going to go into posts and click on edit to bring up a post we've already created. And this would apply to a brand new post or page, and this also applies to pages as well. Now the first thing we can do here is change the title of the post. You can change your URL here, so you just click on edit and we can change this to anything we like. Just remember, if you do change your URL, and just click OK to change that. If you do change your URL, it will change it throughout the internet. So if somebody has bookmarked your page, just remember that changing it will mean they can no longer find your page. This area here is where you edit your blog post. And you can see here you've got a visual tab, which is the most easy way to work on your blog post. And you have a HTML tab which shows all the coding of that page should you need to do that. Now here you have some very basic options. If the options are not showing here, then it's most likely this button here, which is called the kitchen sink. So just click on the kitchen sink and it will bring up all the options available to you in this particular theme. Now the rest of the page, input page here, is where you'll have lots of other different boxes and areas where you can input information. First thing I always do is come up here to screen options and make sure that all of these options are ticked so you can see exactly what's available on that page. If something's not showing, then it's most likely that these boxes are not ticked. So we'll scroll down to the next section. Excerpt is something that is used on the internet. It's a short snippet of your blog post or page, and some themes use it and some themes don't. So if you need to manipulate an excerpt or put something in specifically, this is the box you would use for that. The send track back box is here should you need to use that. The most important box is the custom fields box. This is where you can add in thumbnails for your blog posts. It can also be where you add descriptions for the page. This is the area where you would do that. If there's already a thumbnail here, then you just need to change the value or the URL in this box here. So I'm going to change this image. So I'm just going to pop over to the media library. I'm going to go for my bird of paradise flower image, click on that, and I'm just going to copy the URL, which you'll find at the bottom of each image. Copy that, go back to my post, highlight that and copy the new URL in, and then I'm going to click the update button. Now in order for that to show on your blog post, you need to click the update button here. You can now view the post here. We've just opened this in a new tab. That image that we've put in the custom fields box is this image here. This is the image that shows in the stylized frame of your blog post and for your pages if you've set to have thumbnails on your pages. That is your thumbnail image that goes there. And this is the image that is used throughout the website. So it's important that that image that you'd like to show up is here in the custom field section. Now, the next boxes below are discussions, so you can tick and untick whether you want to allow comments or trackbacks and pingbacks on this particular blog post. And comments will show, all the comments that you've received for this particular blog post will show here. Below is the slug box where, again, you can change the URL of the page, and you can also change who the author is. And the last box just shows which revisions have been done when and by whom. And just remember, any changes, click Update. And in the right hand column, you have options to choose which category your blog post appears in, and you can have more than one. You can also choose your tags or add new tags for your blog post. And these features are pretty much identical for pages, except for a few minor differences. So we'll just head over to Pages now, and we'll click on the About Us page. And you can see here that the page looks very similar. Remember to go into Screen Options and tick all the available options so you can see everything that's in there, and click again to close. And here we've got the About Us heading. Here we have the URL of the page, which you can change. And here we have the text box of the post, that of the page that you're creating. Again, we have visual and HTML tabs. If you'd like to add an image to your About Us page that's not the featured image, that's not the thumbnail that appears on the page, then you just click wherever you'd like the image to appear. Click on this button here, and you can upload directly from your computer or click on the media library, and you can choose whichever image you like. Click Insert into Post, and there you are, you've added an image. So you can do a lot of many different things here. You can do lots of different styling, and then when you're happy, you can click Update, and those changes will have saved. Now down below again, the excerpt box is the same as previously. Your thumbnail is the same. The only difference here with the custom fields on pages, and this is dependent on your theme, is you might have an option to put a description heading in. And all that involves is selecting description from the drop-down list and typing what you'd like to say. This is a description. And click Add. And click Update. And now we'll go to the website and have a look at that. So we go to the About page. And you can see here that you have the heading About Us. This is a description. And then the block of text. And you can see here that image that we've put in. The thumbnails are not usually added to pages unless you specifically select that in your ePanel options. It's under General Settings. You'll find that under Appearance and your Theme Options, and you'll go to Layout Settings, and you'll go to Page Layout, and you can see here Place Thumbnails on Page. We haven't got that enabled, so thumbnails won't show. So if you'd like them to show, just click that there. So this is our About page, and there's a main heading, there's a description, text, and that image that we've put in. Now if we go back to the page, the other options we have are we can allow comments on the page, trackbacks and pingbacks. Generally, as a rule, we untick those for pages because they're more like permanent pages of the website rather than posts, which we're happy to receive comments on. Here you can change the URL of the page, you can change the author, and you can change the revision. And pages don't have categories, so all you need to do is make sure that parent page is correct. If it's just a page on its own, select no parent. And you can choose different templates. We had a default template on this before, but we can change it to full width. And you can change the order that your pages appear in as well. Now all you need to do here is click update, and if we go to that page now and just click the refresh button, you can see here now it's changed it to a full width page. So that's how you can update or create pages and posts and make sure that all your elements are in the right place for your elegant theme.